Our last input is the cost of equity. To find this input, we will use the capital asset pricing model we learned earlier in this course. Here is the CAPM equation. It says that the expected return is the risk-free rate plus beta times the market risk premium. We therefore need estimates for these three inputs: the risk-free rate, Walmart's beta, and the market risk premium. Let's start with the risk-free rate. The risk-free rate is the rate or yield offered by government bonds. We learned all about government bonds and their yields in course 1. Here is a table with information on government bond yields for different maturities. Standard practice for corporate valuation is to use a yield that corresponds to a 10-year maturity. In this case, this yield is 2.19%. Now, let's move to Walmart's beta, which, as we have discussed at length, is a measure of the risk of Walmart's equity. I find Walmart's beta on Yahoo Finance. It is 0.577. Finally, we need the market risk premium. The market risk premium is the additional return we expect to obtain by holding the entire market over and above the risk-free rate. This number is difficult to estimate, but most estimates are between 3% and 6 to 7%. We will use 5%. Plugging these values into the CAPM equation leads to a cost of equity of 5.08%. We can now add this last input to our weighted average cost of capital inputs table.